I welcome you all in our today's session, that is Infinite Impulse Response Filter. In this session, we are going to see some introductory part of IIR filters. Basically, a digital filter is a linear time invariant discrete time system. There are two different types of filters, that is finite impulse response filter and infinite impulse response filters. The FIR filters are of non-recursive type. So what is mean by non-recursive type? Here the present output sample depends on the present input sample and also on the previous input samples. The IIR filters, that is infinite impulse response filters, are of recursive type. Now what is mean by recursive? In recursive type of filters, the present output sample depends on the present input, past input samples, and also on the past output samples. The properties and the design of FIR filter we are going to discuss in our next few videos. Now in this session we are going to design the IIR filter that are realizable and stable. The impulse response H of N of the realizable filter is equivalent to 0 for all the values of N which are greater than or equivalent to 0. And for stability, it must satisfy the condition, which is nothing but summation from n is equivalent to 0 to infinity, modulus of h of n should be less than infinity. IIR digital filter have the transfer function of the form h of z is equivalent to summation from n is equal to 0 to infinity h of n into z raised to minus n, which can also be represented as summation from k is equal to 0 to m bk into z raised to minus k, the whole divided by 1 plus summation from k is equal to 1 to n ak z raised to minus k. The design of an IIR filter for the given specification is nothing but to find out the filter coefficients aks and bks. Okay, that means we have to just find out these coefficients aks and bks. Okay, so that is nothing but the design of our infinite impulse response filter. Okay, now we are going to see the frequency selective filters. Okay, so what is mean by a filter? A filter is the one which rejects the unwanted frequencies from the input signal and allows the desired frequencies only. Okay, the range of these frequencies that are passed through the filter is called as the passband, and those frequencies that are blocked are called as the stopband frequencies. The filters are of different types. So what are those types? Okay, first one is the low pass filter. Okay, the second one is nothing but the high pass filter. Okay, third one is nothing but the band pass filter. And the last one is nothing but the band reject filter. Okay, we will see the filter types one by one. So firstly we start with the low pass filter. Okay, so what is mean by the low pass filter? The magnitude response of an ideal low pass filter allows low frequencies in the pass band. Okay, so it will allow the low frequencies. Okay, the magnitude response of this low pass filter is given here as Okay, so this is the magnitude response of the low pass filter. Okay, the pass band for the low pass filter is in the range from 0 to ohm C. Okay, so this frequency is nothing but the ohm C. Okay, this is for the ideal filter. The dotted line here indicates the ideal response of the low pass filter. Okay, the higher frequencies in the stop band which are greater than the ohm C are blocked here. Okay, so the frequencies which are greater than this ohm C gets blocked for the low pass filter. Okay, so that's why this range is known as, or this band is known as the stop band. Okay, the frequency ohm C between the two bands is the cutoff frequency. Okay, so this frequency is nothing but the cutoff frequency. Okay, what is the magnitude here? The magnitude is given as is equivalent to 1 divided by root 2, that is 0.707. Okay, this is nothing but the cutoff frequency. In practice, it is impossible to obtain the ideal response. Okay, the practical response of the low pass filter is shown as the solid lines in this figure. Okay, so this solid line indicates the practical response of the low pass filter. Okay, so here will be our cutoff frequency. Okay, now what is the high pass filter? The magnitude response for the high pass filter is given here as okay, so in case of high pass filter, the high pass filter allows high frequencies above the ohm, which is greater than the ohm C. So ohm C again here is the cutoff frequency. Okay, and it rejects the frequencies in between ohm is equal to 0 to ohm is equivalent to ohm C. The magnitude response of an ideal and practical high pass filter is shown in this figure. So this dotted line indicates the ideal response, while the solid line indicates the practical response here. Okay, so this is the pass band and this is nothing but the stop band for the high pass filter. Now what about the band pass filter? Okay, so it allows only the band of frequencies in between ohm 1 and ohm C. Okay, So here is nothing but the response for the band pass filter. Okay. This is nothing but the pass band for the band pass filter, while this is nothing but the stop band for the band pass filter. Okay, so this one is nothing but ohm 1 and ohm 2. Okay, so these are the frequencies ohm, and this is the magnitude response for the band pass filter. Okay, so here it allows the frequencies in between ohm 1 and ohm 2 only and stops all other frequencies, okay, other than the frequencies in between pass band. Okay, so ideal and practical response of band pass filter is shown here in this figure. Okay, so this is the ideal response, and what is the practical response here for stop band? Okay, so here it gradually increases. Okay, gain here will decrease, the gain increases and will gain increase in this way. Okay, so this is nothing but the 1, and this is the 0.707. Okay, so this is our ohm L. This is nothing but our ohm U. Okay, so here is the ohm 1 and ohm 2. So this one is ohm 1, while this one is nothing but the ohm 2. Okay, so this is our practical frequency response for the band pass filter. Okay, in the same manner, what about the band reject filter? Okay, in case of band reject filter, it rejects all the frequencies in between the frequencies ohm 1 and ohm 2 and allows all the remaining frequencies. Okay, so ideal response for this band reject filter is given here. Okay, so this is nothing but the stop band for the band reject filter, and this is the pass band for the band reject filter. Okay, so here is the pass band, while this is the stop band. This is our frequencies ohm 1 and ohm 2. Okay, so it will pass all the frequencies instead of the frequencies in between ohm 1 and ohm 2. But this is the ideal frequency response. Now, what is the practical frequency response for the band reject filter? Okay, in the similar way, you can say here, gradually decreases, again it increases. Okay, so this is the practical response, magnitude response for the band reject filter here. Okay, so this magnitude is 1.0. Okay, here it will be 0.707. Okay, so these frequencies are our lower cutoff frequency and upper cutoff frequency. This is the lower cutoff frequency, while this will be the upper cutoff frequencies. Okay, and these are nothing but our ohm 1 and ohm 2 frequencies. Okay, so this is the practical frequency response for the band reject filter. Okay, so we have seen the low pass filter, high pass filter, band pass filter and band reject filter. Okay, for all these filters we have observed the magnitude response, that is ideal magnitude response as well as the practical magnitude response here. Okay, now how to design the digital filters from the analog filters here. Okay, so design of digital filter from analog filters. Okay, the most common technique used for designing IR filters, known as the indirect method, involves first designing an analog prototype filter and then transforming this prototype to the digital filter. So what we have to do, we have to firstly design the analog filter, and then we have to convert this analog filter into the digital filter. Okay, so for the given specification of digital filter, the derivation of the digital filter transfer function requires three main steps. So what are those steps? The first step is map the desired digital filter specifications into an equivalent digital filter, analog filter. Okay, so firstly we have to map the desired digital filter specifications into an equivalent analog filter. Okay, and then secondly, what we have to do, we have to derive the analog filter transfer function for the analog prototype. And lastly, what we have to do, we have to transform the transfer function of the analog prototype into an equivalent digital filter transfer function. Okay, so these are the main three steps while designing the digital filter from the analog filter. So firstly, what we have to do, we have to map the desired digital filter specification into an equivalent analog filter. Okay, then we have to derive the analog transfer function from the analog prototype. And lastly, what we have to do, we have to transform the transfer function of the analog prototype into an equivalent digital filter transfer function. Okay, so here we are going to now observe the specifications for the magnitude response of the low pass filter. Okay, so analog filter, digital filter, and then the alternative specifications of magnitude response of the analog low pass filter. Okay, so firstly we will see the analog filter response for the low pass filter. Now see here, okay, the figure 1 shows the specification for the magnitude response of analog low pass filter. Okay, and this figure shows the specifications for the magnitude response of the digital low pass filter. Okay, so here this range shows the pass band. Okay, the range in between omega p to omega s is nothing but the ohm p to ohm s is nothing but the transition band, while the region greater than the ohm s is nothing but the stop band here. Okay, so here omega p represents the pass band frequency for the digital filter, omega s represents the stop band frequency for the digital filter, omega c represents the 3 dB cutoff frequency. Okay, so epsilon is the parameter specifying allowable pass band, while the lambda represents the parameter specifying the allowable stop band here. Okay, so these are nothing but the allowable stop band, allowable pass band parameters. Okay, so this magnitude response is for the analog filter, and this is nothing but the magnitude response for the equivalent digital filter here. Okay, so the analog filter and digital filter magnitude responses are shown here. Okay, the parameter epsilon is given as 2 into square root of delta p divided by 1 minus delta p. Okay, while the lambda is given as square root of 1 plus delta p of bracket square minus delta s of bracket square, the whole divided by delta s. Okay, so here delta p represents the passband error tolerance. Okay, delta p is nothing but the passband error tolerance, while delta s is nothing but the maximum allowable magnitude in the stop band. Okay, so using the analog filter specification, the transfer function of the analog filter is designed and it is transformed into the digital filter using suitable transformation methods. So among the transformation methods available, the bilinear transformation is useful and it is usually used to design the filters like low pass, high pass, and band reject filter. Okay, so these are the different parameters we have seen up till now for the low pass filter, high pass filter, band reject filter and the band pass filter. Okay, also we have seen how to or what are the different steps to convert the analog filter into the digital filter or how to design the digital filter from the given analog filter specifications. Okay, so in next few lectures, we are going to design the digital filter from the analog filter specification. Thank you.